Thanks for signing up for my 10-minute yoga recovery sequence. Let's just get started. We're gonna start on our hands and knees, tabletop position. So shoulders over your wrists, hips over your knees. Now I want the folds of the elbows, the crease right here, I want that facing forward. This helps to lock the shoulder girdle and give you a little bit more stability there. Engagement of the lower belly helps you not to dip into the lower back. So nice strong engagement there. So now as we exhale, we're going to start moving. So we're going to shift the hips back, release the head to the ground. Inhale, float back up to tabletop. Exhale, shift back. Inhale and come up. One more time, exhale. And inhale. Come back to center. And we'll make our way into cat-cow. So as you inhale, you're going to bend a little bit at the elbows, drop the belly and look forward. And exhale, press into your hands to round the spine, drop the head. Inhale, drop the belly. Exhale, press back. And one more time, inhale. And exhale. From here, keep your hips over your knees. Walk your hands out to allow your chest to sink towards the floor. You can allow your forehead to rest on the ground or your chin. If the forehead doesn't quite make it to the floor, always use a block, a support, to give you some support. Again, here, feel the nice openness through the underarms, the rib cage, allowing the lungs to expand. Walk your hands back into tabletop. Then we'll take the right leg, and we're going to step it in between our hands. Then we're going to sink the hips down. We're going to look forward as we inhale. Maybe coming to our fingertips here. Then as you exhale, you're going to shift the hips back, lengthening the front leg, flexing the toes towards you. And then again, inhaling, coming forward into your lunge. And exhale, coming back. Inhale, walking forward. This time we'll hold here. Feel the hips open. And with your next inhale, let's come up, arms come up overhead to really get a little bit more into this hip flexor. I want you to be conscious that your hips are square to the short edge of the mat and that you're not opening and coming as deep and coming deep like this. I want the hips square so you really get the front side of your leg. Two more breaths. One more. Exhale the hands to the ground, and we'll shift the hips back, coming into our half splits or our hamstring stretch, and fold to hold. One more breath. Walk your hands forward, bend your front knee. And we'll take the right foot, bring it back, coming back into our tabletop, and we'll bring the left leg through. Again, the foot comes in between the hands. Allow the hips to sink down, and then inhale, lift the chest, gaze forward. And exhale, shift the hips back, lengthening the leg, toes come towards you. Inhale, come forward. And exhale, come back. This time we'll stay forward here for a breath. And then as you inhale, rise up, lift your torso, arms come up overhead. And again, if it helps to bring your hands back down to the hips to help make sure that your hips are nice and square, go ahead and do so. And then just bring the arms back up overhead. Feel a nice stretch through the front side of your leg. Two more breaths. And with your exhale, release the hands to the ground. Shift the hips back. And we'll hold here. One more breath. All right, walk your hands forward, bend the front knee, step your left foot back, coming back into tabletop. From here, we're going to come to a kneeling position. I'm going to walk through this next flow first, and then we'll work with it breath on breath. So we're going to start in kneeling position, arms up overhead. As we exhale, we're going to come into child's pose. So arms extended as far forward as you can, hips reach back. And as we inhale, we're going to come forward. We're going to keep our shoulders over our wrists, but then we're going to put our weight into the tops of our feet, lift the knees, but then sink the hips coming into up dog. Make sure the shoulders are rolled back and down and you don't look like this. That's what we don't want. We want them back and down. And then as we exhale, we'll come back to our knees, shift back to child's. And then to inhale, we'll roll up our spine, bringing our hands back up overhead. Okay, so we'll go a little bit faster here. So we'll exhale down to child's. Inhale, shift forward, come to the tops of your feet, sink your hips, shoulders back and down. Exhale, release the knees, child's pose. Inhale, roll up, arms up overhead. Exhale, child's pose. Inhale, up dog. And shoulders back and down. Lower belly is engaged. Exhale, child's. Inhale, roll up. One more time. Exhale, lower. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, child's. Inhale, rolling up. And exhale, hands come to prayer. All right, now we'll make our way onto our back to do some finishing poses. All right, we're going to do a bridge roll. So what that consists of is your knees are going to be bent, feet are going to be planted firmly on the ground. As we inhale, we're going to lift the hips, arms come up overhead, and exhale, lower down. Inhale, rise, exhale, and lower. Inhale, and exhale. Let's go two more times. Inhale, exhale. Last time, inhale, and exhale. Arms come up to T, palms face up. Bring the feet to the width of the mat. And now we'll just windshield wiper our knees. So we'll drop our knees first off to the right. Nice and slow, don't just let them drop. Mindfully let them fall. Then we'll inhale to center and exhale the left side. Inhale and exhale. Inhale, exhale. Let's go one more time, both sides. Slowly letting them drop to one side. Inhaling through center. And letting them drop to the other side. And now as they come back to center, bring your knees into your chest. Your nose comes up to your knees. hold here. And then slowly release, bringing your arms to the ground. Your legs extend long. Taking a few breaths here for a nice short Savasana or corpse pose. Just relax and focus on your breath. One more deep breath in. Exhale. Roll onto your left side. Coming into a fetal position. Take a breath here. And then press your right hand into the ground to just help yourself up. Coming back into a seated position. Bringing your hands in at prayer. From the bottom of my heart, thank you for joining me on my mat today. More importantly, thank yourself for showing up. Namaste.